What's up, guys? Everything Apple Amateur here, because I will never feel the same about what I do after watching this video I'm going to share with you today. Something that impressed me to no end. I've literally never seen a video more impressive than this one that made me question who I am and what I do as a channel. So I just wanted to introduce you to Scotty. This guy actually made a video a little while ago about him assembling an iPhone 6S from spare parts in China. So we've been talking over email a little bit, and he let me use some of the footage from his latest video, the one where he installs a damn headphone jack in an iPhone 7, one that took Apple lots of courage to remove.
Now, some people have asked why we would remove the analog headphone jack from the iPhone. It really comes down to one word: courage. The courage to move on, do something new that betters all of us.
And is this the ultimate act of cowardice then, to bring it back? What is that definition there? It is, guys, just take a moment, please. In the video description down below, there is a video link, and I wanted to share that with you. You know, just go watch it if you haven't already. This is seriously the most entertaining 30 minutes I've watched in forever. Anyways, this guy goes through the ins and outs of installing a headphone jack in an iPhone 7, a device that was sealed off, that didn't have one, that required an adapter to do so. So this guy went through lots of trial and error to make it happen. And I wanted to just literally talk about this monumental thing with you. When Apple says that a feature isn't going to be there, that it's gone, you know, they don't support it in any way, and this guy just brought it back. He literally had the craftiest solution for bringing it back, and that's literally to take an iPhone 3.5 millimeter jack adapter to Lightning and literally make his own personal circuit board version of it and install it inside of here. Problem is, the space which he actually found was occupied by a barometric air vent that didn't really do much for him, so he removed that from the chassis and then drilled his own hole, eventually getting much better with machining. But the process that it took him, you know, the journey was incredible, guys. I totally recommend you watch it. And if you guys remember, a very long time ago when the iPhone 7 just came out and I installed the glowing Apple logo with Trung, the custom one, well, not me, but in collaboration with him, we talked about doing a headphone jack project very similar to this one, you know. And I want to let you guys know how that went. The reason I never posted about it, because it was possible to install one in the phone, but turns out the connections, the wiring, we weren't as crafty as Scott, so we just kind of gave up there. It didn't really happen. This guy, though, managed to make it work, managed to install it, not without sacrifice. So he broke a lot of components, a lot of iPhone screens to make that happen, but just imagine having a headphone jack with the latest hardware, the latest camera, and everything on your iPhone 7. And I feel like it'd be a lot easier to do on a 7 Plus, although that may create its own unique challenges. Anyways, this guy is actually selling that unique printed circuit board he used in order to wire this up for $30, and I'll leave a link for that down below as well. I just encourage you guys, go watch this video. Let me know what you think in the comments. I kind of want to have a little discussion with you guys about this. This headphone jack idea, would you do it on your phone? Would you sacrifice your water resistance in order to make that happen for what, like $30 to $50? Or would the headphone jack adapter be enough? I find it interesting that this actually came out days before the new iPhone 8 is going to be released. And if you can imagine, that thing is probably on a whole nother level of compact inside. Like, there won't be space like there is on this guy, the barometric vent or whatever it's called, in order to accommodate a headphone jack. But I'd be very curious to see, to watch a video if this guy did attempt something like that. That'd be very interesting. Not even succeeded, just tried. The headphone jack is not coming back. There's no way, but this guy kept it alive in the iPhone 7. As crazy as that sounds, it's incredible. Personally, the headphone jack situation hasn't affected me at all. I've completely transitioned to Bluetooth, no cords. The AirPods are one of the most magical products I use in my life right now. I mean, my car has Bluetooth audio. So my life doesn't require a 3.5 millimeter jack. You get into those situations once in a while where, you know, you are in a different environment, you don't have Bluetooth access, so there is a cable and a simple aux solution, yet you don't have your adapter on you. So those are the only situations where I would need one. Although, you know, I can't discredit how awesome this video is. Go check that out, guys. Let me know what you think down below. If this is something that you would even want to do, if you would consider it, if it was actually on the market, because he is considering some sort of solution if you could make it to work, fit better, a little bit less risk of damaged phones. Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this little mini discussion about this. I just thought this was such a monumental thing, something that I even attempted to do with Trung, a project that we had in mind. It was his idea, I mean, not mine, but it didn't work out for us. To see this guy actually succeed and find his own crafty trick to make it happen was so cool. So check that out, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Peace.